everyone, today I'm going to be solving a question about liquid-liquid extraction where the flow rate and composition of my feed and solvent are given and I have to find the extract and raffinate compositions and flow rates over here. Okay, now looking at our diagram over here, there are two inputs in the system. One of them is the feed, one of them is the solvent, and these two combine and they mix at a mixing point over here. And then later, that mixing point, it splits into two outputs, the raffinate and the extract. So the composition of feed and solvent must equal to the composition of the mixed stream M, and similarly the flow rate and composition both actually. So the flow rate and composition of the mixed stream must also equal to the flow rate and composition of the raffinate and extract as expressed in both of these equations. So this is as simple as saying that if the feed is 250 kilograms an hour and solvent is 400, then the flow rate of my mixed stream is going to be 650. Now we start our question by first identifying our feed and solvent and marking them on our diagram. So this is my solubility equilibrium curve, and it's expressed as a right angle triangle. Some of them are expressed as an equilateral triangle, but I'll teach you how to read this. So this is the orange curve marked over here. This curve marked over here is our solubility envelope, and the other curve over here is our conjugate curve. Now, the conjugate curve can be used to help find us the relationship between two inputs or the relationship between two outputs. So the conjugate curve helps to find us the relationship between feed and solvent or the relationship between extract and raffinate, and we'll see that later. Okay, and this is where the solute is marked, and this line is where the diluent is marked. So if a compound, if something, either feed, stream, extract or raffinate, if it is a binary mixture, it's gonna lie on one of the lines of the triangle. Otherwise, if it's a ternary mixture, it's gonna lie somewhere inside the triangle. Now our solvent is 10% acetone and 90% chloroform. So acetone, this is our solute over here. So this line represents 50%. So this line somewhere over here is going to represent 10%. And we mark this point on the line of the equilateral triangle. Now coming back to our feed is 55% in acetone, 5% in chloroform, and the remaining 40% in water. So we can mark our feed by making a horizontal line at 0.55. It's going to be somewhere over here, and this point is going to meet on our solubility curve over here. Or we could do one more thing. Since 40% is water or diluent, the weight fraction, we can make a line vertically up until it reaches the solubility curve, and this is where I used to mark my feed. Now one more thing I'd like to mention, so the point where the solubility envelope and plate point and the conjugate curve intersect, it's called the plate point. Now my extract and my solute are going to lie on the left of my plate point, and they're usually denoted by a Y. Their weight fractions are denoted by a Y, and my feed and my raffinate lie on the right side of the plate point, and their weight fractions are denoted by an X. Okay, now I since have explained, I'll just teach you how to mark my feed and solvent. So I taught how this is are going to be our F and this is going to be our S over here, and then we can draw a line to join them, and as explained above, on that line the mixing point should lie. Now we just make some more mass balances over here, the one as explained above, where the flow rate of the mixed stream must equal to the flow rate of feed and the solvent. And looking at our second equation over here, it simply states that the amount of acetone in the mixed stream, so the weight fraction of acetone in the mixed stream, something like this, XAM, should equal to the weight fraction of acetone in the feed and should equal to the weight of acetone in the feed plus the weight of acetone in the solute. So basically what MXAM is just the flow rate multiplied by the weight fraction. So this basically gives the weight, the amount of acetone in the mixed feed must equal to the amount of acetone in my two inputs. Now XAM is the only unknown over here, and we do some algebraic juggling until we find 0.273. Let's mark the 0.273 on our diagram. Since this is 0.25, 0.273 is going to be somewhere up above, and like we said, our mixed stream M should lie on our FS line. So on our FS line, we're gonna mark M, which is going to M, which is going to be our mix stream. Now, the important point is it should lie on our FS line. And like we talked about before, since M also equals E plus R, it should also pass through the ER line. Okay, now once we've marked our XAM, what we can do is we can choose a random point E on the left side of our solubility curve. So let's say I chose this point E over here, and I'm going to use the conjugate curve to find where R is. So I'll draw a horizontal line, and then I'll drop it down vertically until it reaches the solubility envelope, and this is going to be my R, as shown in the green line above. Then I draw a line through E and R, and see if this is passing through the mix point M. It is not passing, so that does not make sense due to conservation of mass, because, you know, everything that is input must equal everything that is output, like the input flow rate should equal to the output flow rate. Okay, so this point is just too low, it's not ideal. So I need to choose a point E which is a bit high up. So I chose a point E which is a little bit high up, and then I drew another conjugate, and then I dropped, and then I found another R over here. And when I draw these lines, this E is a little bit too high. So it means we need to conduct a third trial until I find the right amount of the right E, with the right E where the line ER also passes through point M. Okay, so in my third trial, I picked up this point, and if I make a conjugate here and I drop it down here, it matches R, and then this passes through M. So these are my final locations of E and R. Now I can use these locations to find the solute concentration in both the extract and the raffinate, and then I can use those to make a mass balance. So the solute concentration in E, I'm going to draw a horizontal, and then find this is a little bit more than 0.25, so this is 0.3 once I do this with a ruler. Similarly, I can find the dilute concentration, which should be here, diluent for the extract. Similarly, the diluent concentration for the raffinate is going to be 0.83 as mentioned over here. And I can draw a horizontal, and I can mark the solute concentration in the raffinate, which is going to be 0.16. Then again, I'm going to write an equation over here, which represents the mass balance. It is similar to the equations we wrote before. The first one, where all of the flow rates should equal, output flow rates should equal to the flow rate of the mix stream. And secondly, the amount of acetone or solute in the mix stream should equal to the amount of solute in both the output streams. Now we have two unknowns over here, E and R. These weight fractions over here have been given in our graph. We found them out as written before. So I will do some algebraic juggling until I find both E and R. Now these are my final flow rates and my final compositions, but I can use one more tip to recheck my calculations. So to recheck my calculations, I can say all of the acetone that has been output of my system must equal to the solute or acetone that is input into my system. So this is the amount of acetones input into my system, which is basically the flow rate multiplied the weight fraction of both the amount of acetone in feed plus the amount of acetone in solvent, and this information is given in my question. So I insert these values, and this is the information I found out from my calculation, and I insert these values, and they should both equal over here. So 125 for R, I just inserted these values over here, and then I saw that they should equal. But they come out to be very close, which gives me confidence that my calculations are basically correct. So that's all I have for you guys. I hope you enjoyed my video. Thanks.